Hello, math students. Let's take a look at solving square root equations. We learned about square roots last week and also other roots and all their properties. So let's use what we know to solve square root equations. So how do you solve an equation that contains a square root? So here are the steps. First thing you want to do is you want to isolate the square root. The expression with the square root, you want to isolate it. Then you want to raise each side of the equation by the second power. It's called squaring both sides. Then you simplify. So here's what I mean by that. How do you isolate the square root? Step one. Well, you see it says square root of x plus 2 equals 3. So the way you isolate that square root is you take the square root here and you subtract 2. And by doing that, you now have the square root all by itself on one side of the equal sign. That's called isolating the square root. Well, step two says to raise each side of the equation by the second power once you've isolated the square root. It's called squaring both sides, or square both sides. So let's square both sides of the equation. So take this, raise this to the second power, raise this to the second power, and of course you know and I know that the second power and the square root are inverses of each other. So you end up with x equals 1 times 1 is 1. And there you have it. That's your answer. Now, if you wanted to check your work, you probably should. This is how you would check it. Quick check. Here's my check. So I'm going to take 1, plug it in for x, plus 2, and see if it equals 3. See that? All I'm doing is I'm taking this number 1, plugging it in for x, and seeing if it works. So square root of 1 is 1, plus 2. Does 1 plus 2 equal 3? The answer is yes, that's true. So we just verified that my x equals 1 is the correct answer. Let's try another one. Let's try to solve for x here. So again, isolate the expression radical x. So this is 4, subtract 4. See, a lot of mistakes here made. Some people think this negative sign is connected to the 4. No, it's not. It's connected to the radical x. That negative sign needs to be eliminated. So let's divide both sides by negative 1. It becomes a positive, right? Let's take the square root of each side. Or not the square root, but let's square both sides. 3 times 3 is 9. There you have it. Do a couple more. So here, this is a little unique in that when you take a look, the 20 cannot be subtracted. It's under the radical. It's trapped. You cannot subtract 20. I don't want to see this. This is no. Watch. No. Do not do this. That's wrong. You can't do that. That's wrong, because it's under the radical. That's a no-no. Make sense? Cannot do that. Well, you can do this, though. So, we'll eliminate that. So this gives us 25. Because radical x plus, oops. I just got rid of the radical. See, that's why you square both sides, to get rid of the radical. And now you can subtract 20. There you go. Now you're allowed to subtract 20. There is no radical. Doing the math, you get 5 equals x, and that is your answer. You should write it as x equals 5, right? Not the way I did, but hey, live and learn. We'll try to find a couple more. I guess this would be a good one. Here, it's negative 2 times radical x. Isolate the radical. How do you isolate it? Well, this is, you multiply them by 2, so divide by 2. Don't forget the negative sign. And that's positive. Take the square of both sides. What's 3 times 3? 9. What's 2 times 2? 4. value of x, or you should write it as so getting a good feel for how that works. Alrighty. More questions here. Look a little trickier. Let's do a couple. Why not try 4 and 6 and then we'll call it a day. So here's number 4. I don't think I made mistakes, but there it is. Yeah, that's how you do that one. See that? That's how smooth it is. Just keep sticking to the game plan, the rules, and it works out perfect. So let's try number 6. There you have it. All right, I hope that helps. Like always, say study hard and learn a lot, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.